Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. We suggest that viewers who are sensitive to the life sciences ask an adult to watch this video first to ensure it's suitable for that viewer. If you have not already done so, we recommend watching the video on biological interactions before watching this video. This helicopter is helping to put out a forest fire. Natural wildfires are very common, especially when the weather is hot and dry. Many of the animals that lived in this patch of the forest could fly or run away, so it will be all right. But because there were many plants that were killed and many animals that left this patch, we call this fire an ecological disturbance. In this video, we will introduce the following terms: ecosystem communities and biomes, carrying capacity, ecosystem dynamics and stability, ecological disturbance, abiotic and biotic disturbance forces, resilience, and biodiversity. The word community refers to the living organisms that interact with each other in a particular place. Such interactions often mean one organism is eating another one. The word ecosystem means all the community, plus the non-living things in a place. Non-living things include the climate, rocks, soil, sunlight, and water. Ecosystems can be on the land, in the water, or both, such as a pond and the land around it. Ecosystems can cover a small area or a huge area, and they can have a few species or many species. Ecologists divide the world into ecological zones, sometimes called biomes. These zones are made based on the temperature, terrain, and what organisms may live there. For example, the polar zones include the Arctic Ocean near the North Pole and Antarctica at the South Pole. Polar zones have lots of snow and ice. These animals often live in some polar zones. One of the zones near the equator is called an equatorial rainforest zone and is one of the hottest places on Earth, so does not have snow or ice at sea level. These are some of the animals found in equatorial rainforest zones. The term carrying capacity for a species means how many members of a particular species and ecosystem can support by having enough food for them. This bison herd started out small, but since there is so much vegetation they can eat, this ecosystem has a large carrying capacity for bison. That means more bison calves have been able to survive, and the number of bison living in this area is growing. We use the word population to refer to the number of members of a species, so we would say this bison population is growing. Under normal circumstances, the population sizes of species living in an ecosystem is always changing, but only slightly. For example, frogs eat many insects every day, but there are also many new insects hatching from eggs every day. So the population size of insects stays about the same, because the exact population sizes and which species are in an ecosystem are always changing. We say that ecosystems are dynamic. The word dynamic means to change. Sometimes, the number of organisms in an ecosystem changes by a large amount, but in a predictable and in a short-term way. For example, every autumn, these birds migrate from a northern ecosystem to a southern ecosystem, and they will return to their northern ecosystem in the spring. That means when these birds migrate, the bird population is changing in two ecosystems. When the amount of change in an ecosystem species and population sizes are mild and predictable, we say the ecosystem is stable. But when there is a major change in population sizes of species within an ecosystem, we call that an ecological disturbance. In general, that means a lot of organisms die or have to leave due to the disturbance. We can group those disturbances as being caused by abiotic and biotic forces. Abiotic forces are not living. This includes extreme weather events, volcanoes, major asteroid impacts, and fires. Biotic forces are living and include diseases, invasive species, and human activities. We'll give a few examples of these, starting with abiotic factors. Extreme weather events include droughts, floods, and strong winds. These can kill many plants, so create a food shortage for herbivores that eat plants. Without enough to eat, those herbivores may die of starvation or have to leave the ecosystem in search of food. With fewer herbivores, there is less food for predators that eat herbivores, so those predators may die of starvation or have to leave the ecosystem. Volcanoes can cover large areas with hot lava or ash, so kill the plants in those areas. The herbivores that depend on those plants may then die of starvation or have to go to other areas. Asteroid impacts are very rare, but one may have killed all the dinosaurs 65 million years ago. The generally accepted theory is that an asteroid about 6 miles wide landed near the Gulf of Mexico and created a huge explosion. The debris from that explosion went high into the atmosphere everywhere in the world. When the atmosphere changed, that killed most of the life on Earth. Fortunately, now we don't have to worry about asteroid impacts because NASA tracks asteroids near Earth and is likely able to move any that are on a collision course with us. These images were taken by an object that NASA shot at this asteroid just moments before the object hit the asteroid. This DART mission showed that now we have the technology to protect Earth from asteroid impacts. Biotic forces are living. They include diseases caused by bacteria, parasites, fungi, and viruses that can kill organisms. These trees died of infections. Animals are at risk of getting diseases, which can sometimes be spread by ticks. This oxpecker is taking ticks off a giraffe. But sometimes, there are too many ticks, or they carry a bad disease, so the animal can be harmed or killed by the disease. Invasive species are organisms that are not native to an ecosystem, but their populations get big. Those invasive species eat a lot of food, so native organisms starve to death or have to leave the ecosystem in search of food. An example of an animal invasive species are some carp. An example of a plant invasive species is kudzu. Kudzu can cover trees and kill them. As the most powerful species on Earth, humans have been able to change any landscape and any ecosystem for thousands of years. We need fields to grow food, which means we had to clear trees and change the land to make those fields. By making fields, growing, and protecting crops that we eat, we displaced organisms that were there before us. Likewise, we need apartment buildings so we can live inside and other buildings so we can do office or industrial work. But by making cities, we reduce the size of some natural habitats that were being used by other organisms. It's unclear if or how we may have unintentionally harmed various ecosystems around the world. These are topics that policymakers debate when considering local, national, and international laws. Our final topic is resilience, sometimes called robustness. Resilience refers to how easily an ecosystem can be damaged by an ecological disturbance. To illustrate, we'll use an example of an extreme weather event, snow in the spring. This can disturb an ecosystem because some plants only pollinate once a year. So when these flowers are destroyed by the cold, the plant will be unable to make seeds. Fewer seeds this year will lead to fewer plants next year. When the plant population is smaller next year, that means there is less food for herbivores such as grasshoppers. That means next year some grasshoppers will die of starvation or have to leave the ecosystem, which means the grasshopper population will get smaller. And since frogs eat grasshoppers, some frogs will die of starvation or have to leave the ecosystem, so the frog population will also get smaller. This cascade could affect many organisms in the food web. Although the ecosystem will eventually return to a stable state, that might take several years. In this different ecosystem, there are many different plants that flower at different times. So, there will be other plants that will pollinate after this freezing event. That means the total number of plants in the ecosystem next year will be very similar to what it is this year. So next year, herbivores like grasshoppers will still have enough to eat, despite the snow this spring, and the grasshopper population next year will be the same as it is this year. Likewise, the frogs will have enough to eat, so the frog population will be the same next year. When an ecosystem returns to its original and stable state quickly, we say that it has high resilience or high robustness. In contrast, if it takes a long time to return to its original one, we say it has low resilience or low robustness. A key feature that makes an ecosystem have high resilience is to have a large variety of organisms. Having a large variety of organisms is the definition of high biodiversity. In this example, the ecosystem with many different plant species has more biodiversity and greater resilience than the ecosystem with just a few plant species. We'll end where we began. Forest fires are very common. But there are some plants like the jack pine that have seeds that will only open when they are heated by a fire. This means that those seeds are among the first to grow in an area that was burned in a forest fire. This plant adapted trait gives the jack pine species an advantage in repopulating an area after a forest fire. And in so doing, this plant helps to quickly restore an ecosystem that has had an ecological disturbance. So, this plant increases that ecosystem's resilience. Here's a review of this topic. Please pause the video if you wish to read this. If you're interested in practice tests that are similar to state exams, but with detailed, colorful explanations for each answer, then please see our apps in the App Store. Many of these are free and none expire or limit their function. Since we only make educational products for children, none of our apps have third-party advertising, in-app purchasing, or connect to the internet. Please subscribe if you'd like to be notified of future educational videos we make. Thanks for your attention.